Very few of the women who seek assistance from the agencies under the Department of Gender Relations do so in the early stages when adequate interventions can be performed on their behalf to assist with their situation. Most of the victims of domestic violence usually seek help when their situation has reached the tipping point. And when they do, they are more likely to go to an NGO than to any of the government agencies and organizations which manage such situations. This notes Director of Gender Relations, Janey Joseph, was especially evident during the height of the initial COVID outbreak here.
During the COVID period, what we did recognize was that in as much as we did not get those alarming numbers that were increasing in terms of the reports that we were getting, the formal reports to the police and to the crisis center and to the family court, we did note that the NGOs, like Raise Your Voice, etc., were reporting that more people were approaching them. So they didn't necessarily want to go through the formal systems, but they were hurting. What we also recognized was that because there was an economic, economic hardships brought them to the point where they were begging, please help us.
Recognizing the general lack of trust in the public services for those affected by gender-based violence, the department has over the past year taken steps to address this. In 2019, an assessment of the various services revealed the existence of gaps in some.
We also recognize that some services were inadequate. So they provided only some of the services that victims required. So we have been working on the referral pathway for St. Lucia to ensure that we have as many of the services as needed, but more importantly, at the standard that they should be. We also wanted to ensure that all service providers, regardless of what sector they provide the services within, they know of all the other services that are there. So we've been working along with UNFPA and UN Women, Multi-Country Office of the Caribbean, so as to ensure that the referral pathway is very clear and that all service providers know. We also are working on a consent companion that is a document that other persons who are not necessarily direct service providers, but like NGOs and so on, who support victims, can also know where to refer to and how.
The Gender Relations Department is also providing capacity-building initiatives so as to equip the various service providers with a greater understanding of the critical service they provide. The department is hoping with these improvements, public confidence in the system would be boosted, and thus victims of gender-based violence would be more inclined to find help there. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.